know, you've got to stimulate the immune system. And I don't use intravenous vitamin C and a lot of things they use. I don't think that's what's going to do it. It's pancreatic enzymes. Beard was right. Everyone who has a doubt about what I'm saying should read Beard's book from 1911, which we've made available. We've reprinted it. It's available now. You can get it on Amazon. He had the answer then, and it was pancreatic enzymes, not the immune system, not any of these things. In fact, billions of dollars have been spent trying to show that the manipulation of the immune system is going to be the answer to cancer, and it's totally, completely, objectively failed. It's despite the cover stories, you know, in 1986 there was a cover story in Newsweek about interleukin-2, the cure for cancer. Well, no one uses interleukin anymore because it was not only killed people, it was terribly expensive, $250,000 for 6 weeks, but it didn't work. Except for rare cases. There were like 3 cases in the original group that ended up actually living any amount of time. It wasn't the answer. Interferon. My boss, Good, did a lot of research on interferon. It didn't cure cancer. It doesn't cure cancer. It's not going to do that.
You also recommend for people who just want to maintain an optimal level of health and wellness, given the high degree of toxicity. You said 79,000 toxic chemicals are out there in the world, right?
Yeah, 79,000. I read an article just recently about that. Yeah, it's pretty scary. It's a scary world out there. And this idea, you know, particularly with these recent studies that are attacking supplements out there, all of which are nonsensical. Oh, we can get enough nutrition from a balanced diet. I have yet to find a so-called expert that could define a balanced diet. If you're an Eskimo, a balanced diet is nothing but fatty red meat. They didn't have fruits or vegetables. If you're a Maasai, traditional Maasai, balanced diet was raw milk, a gallon a day, and some meat. And nothing else. They didn't eat Maasai. Don't traditionally eat fruits and vegetables. If you live in the high Andes, you're going to be drinking llama milk and eating quinoa. So what's a balanced diet? Nobody knows. And the food supply is so corrupted, you can't get enough nutrition from food, even if you eat organically, because the soils are depleted. I eat organically. You have to take supplements if you want to feel well. I mean, if people want to live optimal physical lives in a terribly polluted world, they need to take supplements, they need to eat organically, they need to do all those things. If they don't want to have optimal health, they shouldn't take supplements. It's that simple. You just don't take them. I work 14-hour days. The reason I'm outlasting my critics, 3 of my big critics have now died of cancer. I will not publicly laugh about it, but maybe in the privacy of my own apartment, I snicker sometimes about it. 3 of my biggest critics are now dead of cancer, tragically, unfortunately. That's too bad. I can't afford to get sick. I follow my first, never trust a doctor that doesn't live by his rules. In my office, Dr. Isaacs and I, we live by our rules. I've done coffee enemas for 30 years. I eat organically. I do carrot juice. Our home is 98% organic. I take a huge batch of supplements. I work 14-hour days, 7 days a week, not because I'm crazy or obsessed. I love my work. And then you know, it's 2 of us. As you said earlier, you know, we don't have Sloan Kettering, Stanford, or Johns Hopkins behind it. The buck stops in my office. There are 2 of us taking care of hundreds of patients all over the world at any given time. And I have to be sharp, in control, and healthy. So I follow my program. I guarantee if I live the typical American diet or live like the average doctor lives, I'd be dead. The stress is too much, the demands are too much, the workload is too high. So I follow my program. And anybody who wants optimal health needs to be on an aggressive nutritional program. You cannot maintain optimal health in this world with all the pollution. And the pollution isn't getting better. It's only getting worse. Recent episode, Japan, our friends in Japan, dumped tons. I understand millions of tons of debris are now going to wash up in Hawaii and the West Coast because the entire houses were swept into the sea. Radioactivity has been dumped into the sea. You know, my liver was not geared to handling that, so I got to use extraordinary means to maintain optimal health. Yes, no one should have to take supplements, and when the world is remade perfectly, none of us will have to take supplements. Until that magical point, you need to take supplements to maintain optimal health. Stress only gets worse. The nutritional quality of our food only continues to deteriorate. Even if you try and eat sensibly and organically, still the quality of the food's deteriorating. And acid rain with radioactivity now fools everywhere, whether it's an organic form or not. This is, thanks, again, courtesy of the Japanese. There's radioactivity in the environment, even up in Maine. In order to deal with that and to maintain optimal health despite those stressors, you need to maintain a really aggressive nutritional program.
I'd like to give the listeners some tools. You talked about sodium alginate.
It's wonderful. It removes heavy metals, which is great, but it also removes radioactivity. I take it regularly. Knocks out radioactivity. It's hard to find, I understand, because when I've spoken and people call our office, we can't find it. Our supplement supplier has it, but they only sell to our patients. So you just have to go on the internet and try and find it. Sodium alginate, it's a seaweed derivative. It's used in industry, actually, as, I guess, a thickening agent.
How much do you recommend for people who are not ill?
Well, you know, for preventative, the thing is you should cycle on and off it because it can interfere with the absorption of certain minerals. So what we have our patients do is take three capsules three times a day away from meals, 5 days each month. And during that five-day period, they go off their supplements. We have all our patients cycle on and off the supplements, whether they have toenail fungus or brain cancer. So they'll do their pills like for 20 days and then go off for five. And during the five-day break, they take the alginate, and that's usually adequate 5 days a month. Three capsules three times a day, nine a day for 5 days. Just do it indefinitely every month for 5 days. And that usually gets rid of heavy metals very simply, non-toxically, non-aggressively, and also gets rid of radioactivity, which is not a bad thing.
I have another question about pancreatic enzymes. I know that now they are finally available from the company that sells them to you, and this was set up in New Zealand. Is it okay for us to take pancreatic enzymes as a preventative measure?
Yeah, first, legally, because of FDA regulations, I have to refer to it as a pancreas product. The word enzyme has certain legal connotations in the FDA lexicon. So it's a pancreas product. It does come from New Zealand. It is made by a process that Dr. Isaacs and I developed. New Zealand has the strictest laws for animal husbandry, for raising animals. We think it's the cleanest place on earth, and that's why we use New Zealand. It comes from pigs because the pig pancreas is most like ours. They're not slaughtering pigs for us. They do it for the meat industry, and normally they just throw the pancreas away and give it to dogs. We buy the pancreases, and it's turned into this pancreas product. I think anyone should take it. I mean, ours is pork-based. If you have a terrible pork allergy, you should use lamb, which is also available. But I think the whole world should take it. I take about 30 capsules a day preventatively.
Will it interfere with anything else?
The only thing it interferes with is with cancer. If you take too many, you might get a stomach ache, but I have patients on 100 and 110 capsules a day, spread through the day, not one lump. And, you know, if you took a 40 or 50 at one time, you'll get a stomach ache.
So you're recommending taking 30 a day?
No, I lead an abnormal life. For the average person, 3 to 5 capsules with meals is adequate. 3 to 5 capsules with meals as a general nutritional supportive aid.
And will it interfere with anything like chlorella or any other type of...
No, literally the only thing I've ever seen it interfere with is cancer. It helps with absorption of other nutrients, breaks down food, they help break down food. I mean, that's what pancreatic enzymes in the conventional world are known to do. They have this nice side effect that they kill cancer cells.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah, so in terms of side effects, only if someone had a real serious pork allergy, then you want to go with the lamb, but that's about it. And if you took too many, you'd get a stomachache. Those are the side effects. I've been doing this 24 years, thousands of patients treated. I've never really seen anything more major than that.
Let's talk about the FDA and the fact that supplements are in a dire threat of being removed from the marketplace and criminalized. This is very, very disconcerting.
People, even those interested in nutritional alternatives, even friends of mine or relatives, just don't understand that the FDA has had a 30-year war against the over-the-counter availability of supplements. And with collusion with the drug company, what they'd like to do is get them all off the market and turned into prescription items, as it's happening in Europe now. So instead of, you know, $5 for a bottle of vitamin C, it'll be $100. And it'll be free because insurance covered. We all think if it's covered by insurance, it's free. We all pay for it. So drug companies could really jack up the price. And drug companies do not like the fact that people come to see people like me, or instead of going on statins, go to their health food store, and the health food store owner, who's usually very knowledgeable, tells them what to do in order to lower their cholesterol. They don't like that. They want everyone on medications, and they don't want supplements available. And in the last year, there's been a real concerted, in my 30 years following the supplement industry, I've never seen anything so aggressive with Durbin and his endless bills. Now he wants to put riders on the bills to basically make it so difficult for supplement manufacturers to stay in business, they will go out of business. And to have such onerous regulation, I mean, it's always done for consumer protection. You know, Ben Franklin said, you know, beware of anybody that wants to help you. And I think there's a lot of truth to that. If someone says, oh, we're doing it for your benefit, you know, look for the door and start running as fast as you can. That's always a dangerous sign, especially when a bureaucrat paid for with tax money says we want to help you. That's a warning sign you're dealing with something perverse.
I have to tell you something that I found out 2 years ago. I'm a member of the Life Extension Foundation out of Florida. I really love reading all of their research, and I rely on them for my blood tests. And they had done a lot of research on avocado extract, which was formulated. And when people would take this avocado extract, they were losing a ton of fat. Well, the FDA got a hold of this. because one of the pharmaceutical companies wanted to patent avocado extract. So